Let's make a simple scene for rendering our sofa models. I'm thinking about some white concrete walls and perhaps a floor, something like this, dark and shiny polished concrete or something similar. Can't really tell what it is. Okay, so first let's create a box. Let's set it to 350 height, and let's say 3 by 6 meters large. Okay, maybe 4. Doesn't really matter since we're not gonna be seeing a lot of the room. Okay, let's convert it to editable poly. Delete these top and bottom polygons. Actually, let's move this back so we have more space for our camera. And add a shell modifier just to give the walls some thickness. Okay, and now let's make some simple boxes for the floor and the ceiling. So that's the ceiling. Shift plus move is down to create the floor. Make a copy. Right, let's create a simple test object. For example, a teapot will work fine. And I'm gonna start by assigning everything a flat gray gray material. Okay, now let's create a V-Ray physical camera. Press C to enter camera view, Shift plus F to see your render frame, and let's move in like this. Okay, now let's set up some lights. We don't really need to create any windows or something like that. We're just gonna use some simple V-Ray plane lights. Okay, I'm gonna use one plane light from this side, sort of like it was a window, and position it over here in the middle of the room, in the middle of the wall, like this. And let's set up a simple test render so we can see how it looks. Okay, so make sure you have set V-Ray as your production renderer. And then let's go over the settings. First, you want to enable the frame buffer. Here it is. And then I'm going to disable the anti-aliasing filter for now. Okay, let's reduce the DMC's image sampler subdivs to 2, this will make it a bit more aliased, but it will render faster and it's very nice for test renderings. Okay, so now let's move to color mapping. This is important that you set it to gamma 2.2, enable subpixel mapping, and let's leave the rest as it is. Right, let's enable the GI. So our first engine will be the radiance map and the second will be light cache. Okay, let's use a very low preset for radiance map. Disable multipass so it renders it in a single go. And then move on to light cache and reduce the subdiv to something like 300 for a test render. Okay, and let's see the calculation phase as well. Okay, maybe let's make the bucket smaller so we can see the progress better. And render. It's a bit dark at the moment, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select my V-Ray camera and adjust the exposure by reducing the shutter speed. So for interior, something like 30 would work fine. Is floating a bit, so let's move it down slightly. Okay, and also for the camera I want to set my white balance to neutral so it doesn't have a weird tint and it's simply gray. Okay, so this looks about right for medium gray material, maybe a bit too dark. Let's add one more light source. I'm gonna go ahead and add the light source in the center of the room. I'm gonna use a V-Ray sphere light. And over top to the ceiling, sort of like a chandelier or something. Maybe let's set the color to slightly more yellow. Okay. And let's increase the strength of our V-Ray plane light slightly. Let's set it to 80. Okay, so I think this will be a decent basic lighting setup. Now let's fix our materials. Okay, so let's start with the walls. I'm gonna go to cgtextures.com and search for concrete. Let's look through these textures to find something nice. Okay, maybe let's try this one. Right, let's check the second page as well. Let's go back. I think I want to use where it is. Okay, here. Let's try this one. Let's download the huge file. Okay. Right, let's crop it. Don't need the bottom part, and we don't need the top part as well. Maybe like this. Now let's create a new layer and fill it with a white color. Try some different blending modes. Right, a soft light looks nice. Let's merge down. Okay, and again fill with white. And maybe just use the normal blending mode and reduce the opacity. Something like this. And let's save the image. I'm gonna save it as a PNG file. Name it as Concrete Diffuse. Right? Now let's go to 3D Max and select our walls object. I'm gonna use a UVW mapping modifier to create some UVs for the object. Just set it to box. And let's create a new V-Ray material for the walls. And let's name it concrete white. Okay. And assign it to the walls. Let's use this bitmap in the diffuse slot and enable showing viewport to see the preview. Alright, so it looks like we need to scale our mapping a bit. Let's scale it this way. It's not stretched out. Let's see how it looks in render. Scaled it a bit too much. Okay, looks good. Now let's create a reflection map. Okay, so let's hide this layer. And I'm gonna use the black and white tool to create a black and white version of this image. Just adjust the sliders until you get something you like. Okay, so something like this maybe. And let's save it. Let's move the UV map a bit so this tricky part is not visible. I don't really like it too much, maybe like this. Okay, and now let's set up our reflection map in the reflect slot. I'm also going to copy this map to my reflection glossiness slot. Okay, let's set the glossiness to 0.6, 0.5 for concrete maybe. And reduce the amount of the map to blend it with the 0.5 value. So let's set it to 50. Looks alright. And enable Fresnel. Set it at something like 3.5. Looks a bit like concrete. Okay, looks nice. And now let's set up a bump map. Okay, so let's undo the black and white. And use the filter high pass. Let's increase the value a bit. Something like this. And maybe play with the level slightly to give it a bit more contrast. Okay. And reduce the saturation to zero. Let's save it. And let's go down to the bump map and set it up. Right. Now let's reduce the blurring for the bump map. Maybe 0.2. And reduce the bump amount to something like 3. Not too strong. Re-render. I think it's gonna be a decent concrete material. Alright, let's set up the floor. Okay, so something like this. Let's start by creating a black and white map first. Let's search for concrete floor. Let's open this large image in Photoshop. And maybe open the plaster textures. Let's look at some of these. Okay, let's take this one. Let's open the large image again. Right. So let's copy this image and paste over this one. Use the free transform tool to fit it perfectly to the dimensions of this image. Okay, let's increase the contrast a bit. And play around with the blending modes. Okay, good. So this image should be tileable since we use tileable textures to create it. Maybe let's increase the contrast a bit. And let's save it as floor mix. Alright. Let's go back. Let's use this one for something as well. Okay, so let's create a new material. Let's name it floor and set up a mix map in the diffuse slot. Okay, so we're gonna use the bitmap. Here it is. And drag and drop on the floor. Maybe let's style it 2x2. Okay. And set up our mix colors to any colors we want. Something dark gray like this maybe. And one slightly lighter. like that. Let's make it reflective. Okay, for that I'm gonna use this image maybe. Really saturate it. And using the curves tool, let's increase the contrast a bit. Okay. And maybe let's blur it slightly. I'm just gonna use the Gaussian blur filter. And save it. Floor reflect. Okay, and let's set it up in the reflect slot. Right, now let's reduce the glossiness a bit. Maybe 0.8385. Enable Fresnel. Let's set it at 4. Yeah, let's unhide all and see how it looks. Maybe let's copy the reflect map to reflection glossiness slot as well. And let's rotate it here 90 degrees, maybe increase styling, just so it's not the same as the reflection map. Okay. And go up and reduce the amount of the glossiness map. Maybe increase the subdivs to get a smoother result. Not gonna be so noisy now. And let's give the floor a light bump map. I'm gonna use the same reflection map in the bump slot. Maybe let's set it to 20. Alright. Looks good. Let's leave it at that. Okay, let's add a simple rug. I'm gonna create a box. Let's reduce the height a bit, maybe 1 centimeter or 0.5. Okay. Collapse the editable poly. Delete the bottom polygon. And let's add some segments, like here. Okay. And now for these horizontal ones as well. Right, and let's add turbo smooth. So this way it has these slightly rounded edges. Looks a bit better. Okay, and let's add a hair and fur modifier. Let's select the style hair option and using this brush tool, maybe make it a bit more interesting. Finish styling. And reduce the scale. Make the hair shorter. This part up slightly. And here as well. Right. Let's select it and create a new area material. Select rug. And set up the diffuse color to something dark and give it some weak reflections. Okay, let's also enable anisotropy by reducing this value here. Maybe rotate it a bit. Okay, so unhide all and render. Okay, so right now we can't see our object because we need to enable it in render effects. Go to rendering, effects, select hair and fur and change it from buffer to mental ray prime. And re-render the scene. Okay, now go to your hair and go to material parameters. Change the root color to almost black, tip color to slightly lighter. And increase the specular a bit. Okay, like that. Let's re-render. It's a bit too shiny. Let's reduce it. Let's do the hue variation as well to 1 and the value variation to 2. Don't want them to be too visible. So right, maybe the strands are a bit too thick and too thin at the ends. Okay, so let's change the root thickness to 8, tip thickness to 2, and increase the hair count to 20,000. Okay, so the carpet or the rug looks okay. Maybe let's brush it a bit. Let's brush it a bit more. Just mess it up a bit. Okay, it looks great. So that's the hair. And maybe let's hang a painting here behind the sofa. Let's make a box. And move it over here. Okay, and let's move it up. Looks like we need to step back with our camera. And scale it up like this. Right, and let's find a nice painting. Let's search for something like modern red painting. Let's search for large images. Okay, let's take this one. Let's wait for it to load. Copy the image, open it in Photoshop. And let's create a new layer and fill it with red. Okay, let's try some blending modes. Let's use this one, merge it down. Let's use curves, bring up the contrast and color. Alright, let's save it. Painting. And go back to max. So new material, name it painting, and set up the bitmap in the diffuse slot. All right, let's give it some reflections, blur them a bit. Enable Fresnel, maybe set it at 4. And we need to use bump map as well to make it more realistic. Alright, let's use the same floor mix map. Maybe this is a bit wrong for this image. Let's use the reflection map. Okay, let's see it on the model, adjust the tiling. Okay, like that. And on this material preview it looks alright. Let's reduce blurring a bit. Okay. And let's render. Maybe red is too strong. I'll change it up a bit. Let's bring it back to black and white. This. And with curves, let's make it darker. Let's increase the scale of hair slightly, since we scaled up the model. Let's bring up the scale of hair as well. Alright. Let's center this as well. Good, looks good. And now we just need to add our sofa, create some materials for it, and render.